Hi everyone, welcome to Alok the Analyst. So this video is all about setting your analytics infra. We have already done a video on how do you get started with a database already. We have done a BigQuery, it's completely free. So you can check that out. We'll use that database here in Metabase as well. So this video is all about setting up Metabase. I had a couple of people requesting this video. So here we go. So we start with a quick Google search. We'll search Metabase and you click the first link. Then you will see two offerings, Metabase Cloud and Open Source. You need to click Open Source. So open Open Source pe chalte hain. So here you need to click Open Source Metabase. Once you do, this is the page you need to focus on. So here you will see a jar file option. What you need to do is click on Download Metabase and you need to move it to a new directory. Post that, you need to run this command in that directory. So what we'll do is, we have downloaded Metabase. So I've already moved it to a directory. So what I'll do is I'll do right click, I'll do open in terminal. We'll just copy this code, we'll paste it and we'll run it. So it takes some time to set it up. Once this runs, you need to go on localhost and port 3000. So this will actually run for a bit. While it runs, what you need to do is you need to add any database to it. So for me, I use BigQuery. So I'll use BigQuery to add as a database there. If you want to know how do you set up BigQuery for free, I have already created a video on it. You will see somewhere in the I button. So make sure you check that out. So what you usually do is you create a service account for this. To create a new service account, directly go to service account. You click create service account. You create a service account name. Let's say Metabase tutorial. Once that is done, you click create and continue. I'll just wait for it to load. For permissions, you can give it BigQuery. If you give BigQuery admin, you can both read and write data. If you only give a viewer access, BigQuery data viewer, then Metabase will only be able to view data. Ideally, in organizations, we don't give Metabase admin access because it's just a data visualization tool. It doesn't need to write database or delete data set from the database. But here for our tutorial, I'll just ignore this. Let's do continue. And let's do done. Once you create this, what you will find is you need to add a key to it. So I'll just let it load. So you need to do add key, create new key, and do a JSON file and click create. Once you have created a JSON file, you will see that JSON file over here. Now let's see if our Metabase has loaded. So instance is already here, so we'll just do run our localhost 3000. So as you can see, our Metabase has been set up. I'll just quickly fill these forms. Test, I'll do test alokthanalyst@gmail.com. Password, I'll do test@123. Password, we'll do test@123. Company name is self. You click next. Not sure. Next. Here you can either add your database later or you can do it over here itself. I'll add it later so that you know in future where to add database from. So perfect. Our Metabase has been set up. You will see there is a sample data set already. So you can look at these data sets if you want to do something on it. But for us, what we'll do is we'll actually add a database. So to add a database, what you need to do is you need to go to settings, go to admin settings, go to databases. Over here, click add database. So we'll select BigQuery. We'll do BQ. Then you select the JSON file you downloaded. Once that is done, you click save. So as you can see, the database was added. You can also config who all can access if you have multiple users in your Metabase. But for us, that is not a problem. I'll just exit it. Now I'll go to databases. Here you can see our BigQuery. So it doesn't have a table yet. Yeah, so I just refreshed it. You will see all the tables that we have discussed so far. So it's still loading, but we did a SQL question. So this is the table for that. Other than that, we did a lot of YouTube data API. You will see that data here as well. You will also see Guardian API. This is another full blown project we did end to end. So this can actually help you get your next job. Other than that, we also have YouTube Fact. We did another portfolio project on YouTube data. So that data is coming from here. So I'll just open a couple of them. So I'll just let it load actually. So as you can see, the table has loaded. It will just take a couple of minutes. So yeah, you can start seeing data now. To write queries, what you need to do is click on new SQL query. You can select whatever database you have and you can just start writing your SQL. So this is how you set up Metabase, and hope this helps. So I'll keep posting new videos every week. So hope this video helps you set up your own infra. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned for more.